Thank you very much for the kind invitation and Mr. Hökmark for the excellent, let's say, overview, starting from the big picture and then going to the technical details. And I think this is indeed one of the files where probably you see those two things coming together. You're talking about a lot of technical details, but in the end, this is also about much more than just those details. It's also about the balance, as you've pointed out, Mr. Hökmark, between, on the one hand, let's say, the burden we're imposing on banks, on the other hand, maybe the benefit we're getting for financial stability. It's also linked to the broader discussion we're having in the banking union, actually, on the balance between risk sharing and risk reduction. I think this is clearly a proposal which is part of the risk reduction side, but of course, also part of the bigger picture here, and of course it is also a proposal about the balance between the national, let's say, discretion which we still have and the European framework which we are having, and I think all this in an area, the banking area, where of course especially in the within the euro area, or let's say within the member states which are part of the banking union, we have seen actually quite a very quick development of centralizing powers or sharing powers more together, which probably has not yet fully been digested by everybody, and also not yet fully been, I would say, implemented. We haven't probably fully yet reached the new equilibrium. We came from a national equilibrium, and we are going, at least in the banking union now, to a much more European equilibrium. And as any change, this is a process which takes place and which takes some time. And probably, I think we have to say, we are not yet fully there. So that, of course, makes it even more difficult to already, again, change and tweak the rules. I think we've never, nevertheless, tried from the Commission to propose this package, together with, of course, a proposal on the which is more than looking at capital and liquidity matters on the CRD CRR side. This is not to give the impression that basically we could already now, after so few years, learn the full lessons from the BRD and from the banking union. Indeed, there is a review of the BRD framework, which, of course, Mr. Hökmark has played an instrumental role in setting up. This review is required and is upcoming at some point. That will be a fundamental review of the whole framework, in the sense of looking what has worked, what has not. We are probably today not yet at the stage that we can fully actually do that kind of fundamental review. And still, we had these international standards of TLAC, which had to be implemented in the EU law. That's why we decided to come forward with this more targeted approach, where we just say, okay, we keep the current BRD framework in place. There are many discussions about individual elements. We don't touch most of them, but we look really at the MREL TLAC part, how we can implement that and fit this into the European framework. And that comes after a first element of the banking package. Of course, the fast track has already been agreed. I think that was generally a good success. We've allowed actually all member states, and we've created clarity for member states and for banks as to what categories of those instruments which qualify for TLAC are there. So banks now have the clarity and can now have the reliability to start building up their buffers. But of course, you also need to indeed then know up to what level you will need to get. And that is, of course, the difficult question which we're dealing with in this package. And once that will be agreed and put together, we will then, of course, have to do what the Parliament and the Council asked us to do, a more comprehensive review of the BRD as a whole. But that will be clearly a next step, and I think I'm quite happy that all, both Commission but also Parliament and Council, at least in the majority, agree that we should keep the focus of this package, because otherwise we will never get anywhere. Can I say? I will maybe just set out a few elements of our proposal, and then maybe a bit complement the perspective on what's going on in the Council. I think, Mr. Hökmark, you have explained what the perspective of the European Parliament is. Indeed, we had proposed to implement the TLAC standard for the banks which are covered by the international standard, so essentially the G-SIBs. And we had indeed done some adjustments to the MREL framework to make sure that the TLAC actually fits into it. And some of the elements which are part of the TLAC framework, for example, the fact that if you breach your TLAC requirements, you have these MDA triggers, the triggers on distributions, or let's say restrictions on distributions kicking in at certain moments. That's something which you, if you fit it into the TLAC framework, you also need to say, well, how does that react actually with the, on the MREL side? We also had to cater for the fact that on the capital side, actually the SSM and also most of the national authorities have since some time let's say, based on build a new Pillar 2 capital framework composed of guidance, hard requirements, and of guidance. And that's also something, of course, as MREL in a way is supposed to put the bank back on its feet and back on fulfilling the capital requirements after a resolution. If you change the capital requirements side, you also need to reflect that to a certain extent on the MREL side. So those are, I think, two areas where indeed we then needed to make some adjustments of the proposal, going a bit beyond the mere kind of copy and paste of the TLAC framework. We have included a number of other very targeted changes, which I think came out of the first, let's say, few years of application of the rules. I think one is indeed on the eligibility of third country debt or debt issued under law of the third country, the moratorium tool, which was already mentioned, which I think has overall been considered by ministers to be a very useful one, and indeed we already have seen that again recently, that it can be situations where you do need such a moratorium. But of course, it is in a difficult balance to strike here. I think those are the key areas in the resolution side which we have proposed in our framework. And all this, of course, to achieve this difficult balance, the balances actually I mentioned before, but in particular within this framework, the balance between on the one hand making sure that you actually can effectively apply bail-in. And on the other hand, that you don't overburden the banking sector and refrain the sector from actually playing the role it has to play, both in the lending to the economy, but also in its capital market financing role. Now, how do we see the discussions going? I think, as I mentioned, Mr. Höckmark has been very, very exhaustive, actually, on the parliamentary side. I think on the council side, we do see a lot of, let's say, reflections in various directions. Unfortunately, I have to say that, let's say, the fundamental issues and the fundamental balance which this proposal has to strike has not really changed since we made our proposal. We had one way of approaching this balance between burden and, on the other hand, effective bail-in, between maybe also legal clarity on MREL TLAC buffers, and the other hand, flexibility for the authorities. I think we had one basically way of approaching it. We introduced the TLAC framework, and we've a bit as a floor, if you want, and we framed this question to the top a bit more than that was the case so far, but still left relatively large amount of discretion there for the authorities. I think we see now reflections in the council and in the parliament to maybe make in some instances, some people say we should make the floor a bit higher or a bit more binding, or we should extend the scope also to other banks, and that is a possibility you can do. But that, of course, then also, if you want to have an overall balance, means that you need to frame even much more, or even limit and cap actually also the flexibility which you have to the top. So I think this balance is something which has to be found. I continue to think that our proposal was one way of doing it. I don't think it's the only one. So we are very, very open to the discussions, but let's say the fundamental issues and the fundamental policy choices won't go away. I mean, you may find different technical solutions to basically to address them, but if you think there's a smart way out and you can say and can have your cake and eat it, that so far at least I haven't seen those solutions. So in light of that, I would want to say that I think the Bulgarian presidency is doing a very, very good job on this package on the council side, and they're really moving the discussions forward. So I'm quite confident that we can actually also go towards at least a general approach on the parliament, on the council side relatively quickly. And we will then, of course, have to see how the discussions continue. But I do hope, that is, of course, our aspiration, our hope, that we provide that clarity for banks relatively quickly, what are the rules in the framework are going to be, which they have to work in. And once that's done and the rules are indeed in place, I think then we will need to also move forward. We will need to look at the broader, let's say, BRD picture, take stock of that. But as I said, I think that's a bit of a second step. First of all, the key task is actually to get this package done.